Welcome back to Decodee's Rapid Developer Tutorial. In this video, we will see how to add different values into child table using client-side scripting. So let's start learning. Here I'm going to add different values into this child table. Let's open this first row. And here we can see three fields. And first field is date, and second is value 1, and third is value 2. Here I am going to add three different values into this field using client-side scripting. So let's open my parent doc.js file. So before that, let's comment this. And here I am going to add that values when we click on enable checkbox. So for that, I am creating one event, and it is a doc field event, and the event is enabled. Inside this event, I am going to add the scripts for adding values to child table. For that, just follow these codes. Let's row is equal to, and we can fetch the child table top fields using this method form.addChild. Inside that method, let's enter the field name of that child table. So let's open my parent document, and here we can see the field name date and value section. Let's write this date and values section. Now we can access different fields present inside this child table. So let's put a comma after child table name and open a curly bracket. The first doc field is date, and I am entering one date inside this doc field 01 03 2021, and put it in quotes and comma. And another field is value 1, and my value 1 is 10, and next field is value 2, and my value 2 is, let's enter 20. So let's save this, and I'm going to open my parent document, refresh the document, and create a new document. Now we can see the child table is empty, and let's click on enable. And now we can't see the values because we didn't refresh this child tables. So let's refresh this child table, and for that we can use another method, and this is an important method, and this method we can use for refresh different fields. So the method is form.refresh field, and let's enter the child table name, and which is date and value section. So this refresh method will refresh this child table, and then we can see the values. So let's verify this and refresh it, create a new document. Now the child table is empty, and let's click on enable. Now also it's not working, so let's check the code. So here we can see one spelling mistake, and which is field. Let's save this again and refresh parent document. And now this is empty, and let's check this box. And now we can see the values, but we can't see the date. It's because the date format is not correct. So let's change this format. And refresh it. and now we can see the date and two values. So we successfully updated the child table using client-side scripting. Before we end up this video, I am going to show one more thing, and which is a simple method, and this method will fetch the current date, and we can see the current date in date field. So let's remove the date, and so for fetching today's date we can use this method frappe dot date time dot get today. This method will return the current date to the date field. So let's verify this, and I'm opening my parent document. Let's refresh this, and now we can see the child table is empty. Let's click on enable, and here we can see the today's date, and which is 10th March 2021. So this is how we can fetch the today's date using get today method. From this video we have seen how to add different values to child table, and also how to fetch today's date using get today method. So let's wind up this video and see you on the next video. Bye.